Welcome back. This is Pastor Craig. It is day 9 of our focused prayer on being a disciple of Jesus who makes disciples. And so as we go through this, just want to keep reminding you, get the app, go to the website, you can get the notes that I'm looking at and the prayer focus reminders to help you in your time of prayer today. We're going to read today from Titus. And in Titus chapter 2, verses 1 through 10, just a small snapshot here, that making disciples, this really is more than just instructing others. It's not just sit down and let me tell you how to follow Jesus and then go. This is about personally living in a way that reflects Jesus. Now, I am aware that today is the election day, and how we've been handling ourselves as Christians through this process is important. You know, it's a funny deal. There's so much tension happening, but potentially after today, within a few days, an election will end, and results will be heartbreaking for some and celebratory for others. But the reality is that our job is to make disciples, not necessarily to worry about those things. Not that they're not important, don't hear that. But I think that if the who's the president is more important than who I know, knowing Jesus, then I think that is a concern. I want us to be good citizens. I think we should be a part of our political system to some point, but not to the point that it overshadows your call to be a disciple maker. So as you read Titus today, I hope that you'll be challenged a little bit to understand that where you live and work and play and learn, where you exist, it's important that you are an example, a living example of Jesus. People need to see you, they need to see Jesus in you, and they need to hear from you who Jesus is, and why in the world would I even follow him? Why would I surrender my life to him? I think this is an important part of this process of this prayer time. As we go to God today, I'm going to ask you to really thank God again for the example of others that he's put in front of you who modeled what it means to be a follower of Christ. In fact, in your prayers today, I'm going to say, when you think of the people in your life that have been a model for you, would you spend time today thanking God personally for them by name? Thank God for, and try to remember, what was it you saw in their life that modeled Jesus for you? That was, I use the word attractional, not in a physical way, but in an attractional way that says, there's something about them that draws me to want to know more about them, but really about Jesus in them. That's really what we're getting at today. So pray for their continued strength and their perseverance. Take time and pray for those people that have been an influence in your life. And remember that if you're in this process of making disciples yourself, there may be somebody praying for you today by name and saying thank you, because maybe you've been an example for somebody else. That, you know, we're not to worry so much about how people are impacted by me. It's not my job to make sure that they're impacted by me or to receive honor for that. But I do want to give God glory in the way I interact with others. So this is your prayer focus today. Spend some time again reading Titus chapter 2, 1 through 10. Go to the Lord in prayer. Ask him to reveal these things to you from the prompts that I provided. And again, thank God for the people in your life who are modeling Jesus for you. And I pray that you will do the same for others. Thanks for joining us today.